Welcome to Your Voice. I'm Julia Lilkindy. Today, Senator John DeFrancisco is with us to tell us what's happening at the end of session. Hi, Senator.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. What's happening? A lot is happening, a lot of hours, and a lot is not happening. Part of the problem with when you get two legislative branches, two legislative houses together in order to pass a bill to get to the governor to sign, there's differences of opinion. And there's different bills that float around until there's a common bill that is able to be passed. So some great things have happened, some things that probably are not going to happen since we've probably got just maybe less than a day left. Mm-hmm. But that's true with every session, and you can't get everything done, and there's differences of opinions. But I think there's plenty that the people will be happy with.
Yeah, I want to talk about some bills that you sponsor, starting with transportation. A bill to help keep fares down and provide better services for people who use CENTRO.
Well, there's a couple of bills that I've been trying to push. One of them is to provide a structure which would provide more funding out of the pots of money that the government collects. Because every year it seems there's a shortfall, and that's because if, for example, mortgage recording tax, when you record a mortgage, when you buy a house, or when you refinance your house, a portion of that goes to CENTRO. If mortgage loans or sales of houses are not happening, automatically that source is gonna be reduced. So we're trying to get that changed. It doesn't look like we're gonna be able to do it before the end of session, but hope springs eternal. The other thing is there's a bill when CENTRO finances and there's certain fees that they have to pay. And I passed a bill in the Senate that would exempt them from one of those fees. It's not millions of dollars, but it'll be additional funds that would be available CENTRO. Hopefully that bill will pass in the Assembly. We've already passed it in the Senate.
When it comes to bridges in New York, nearly 30% of bridges are rated in fair or poor condition. So you sponsor legislation to help secure funding for the Bridge Reform Act, where BRIDGE is actually used as an acronym for Bridge Road Investment Dedicated Fund Guaranteed Enforcement. So tell us what it does.
That's a lot of words, isn't
yes.
it? But you got to have an acronym in Albany in order to, so people understand or remember the bill that you're talking about. And this is very simple. Over the years, the reason this fund was developed was to repair roads and bridges. And over the years, when there was shortfall in government revenues, things that normally that should not have been paid out of that fund include like snow removal. It includes unrelated things that have nothing to do with road work and bridge work, but invaded. And both Republicans and Democrats, when each governor was in office, everybody did the same thing. And unfortunately, the legislature let it happen. This bill says you just can't do that. It's only for the money that's collected from the highway taxes only can be used for repairs and new construction of roads and bridges. That's what was the intent, and I guess the bill really says this was the intent, and we mean it. You know, follow the law.
You have to say that at the end.
Yeah, you mean it. That's what the bill basically does. Hopefully, that will pass in the Assembly, but once again, it's not certain.
The Safe Cars, Safe Streets Act. Tell us what it is.
Well, the main component of it is something I've been trying to do for years, and we've got a same as bill as we had. In the Assembly, and they've passed it. But basically, the main function is if you see someone with tinted windows that you can't see in the window, then that's a danger. It's a danger not only as a pedestrian. How many times you walk across the street, there's a car waiting at a red light, you look over to try to make eye contact to make sure this person saw you and he doesn't just put the foot on the gas as he's going through the light. You can't do that if the windows are tinted where it's so dark. You can have the tint by, I think, 70% reflection of the light. But if it's more than that, you can't see anything. But more importantly is police officers with what's going on today. especially for a traffic stop on a highway, for anything in an urban area. You got people actually targeting police. So they all go up to a car to investigate something, or because someone's reckless driving, and they can't see in the windows. Now, and the way it's been happening is a lot of people police have been hurt or killed by guns. It's just stupid, is basically, I guess, the easiest way to say it. And we've passed this bill year after year. Or putting some type of thing over your license plate where you can't see the license plate number, or to try to avoid detection when you run through an easy pass or something. You know, this stuff is encouraged by not having the tools in order to make sure these things are less likely to happen. But we've got a same as bill. I think we've had the huge support from all the law enforcement agencies, which wasn't necessarily the case in the past. So hopefully the governor will not veto it, and it will get passed because it's important and it's a safety measure.
Mm-hmm. You have been calling for a cost-benefit analysis for the state's energy program, and now the Senate passed a bill that would require it.
Well, unfortunately, again, as I said, some things get done, like the tinted window bill that has a same as sponsor. The bill's the same in the Assembly, and they passed it. This one, it's unlikely to pass in the Assembly. And basically, the reason why not is there's a group of people that believe that money should be spent on anything that's entitled green. And whenever you want to, even if it's not cost effective, or even if it doesn't make sense financially, and the mere thought of the Public Service Commission or NYSERDA, who divvies out billions of dollars out of your rate, out of the rates that you pay, the taxes that you pay on your utility bills, the concept seems foreign to certain people, that you ought to determine what's the cost of this and what's the benefit environmentally or whatever. And then in fact, it helps the environment, so you're not throwing away money at what happens to be the vogue green thing of the day. Mm-hmm. Well, the vote, it only went, we got just basically what we needed in the Senate to pass it, and which I don't quite understand, but that's something that I think would help everything. It'll help the environment, and it'll help the ratepayers, making sure that their money is being used for something that's cost effective. This is not quite the same thing, but remember when everybody was thinking of ethanol, we started using corn to make ethanol, and then all of a sudden we had a shortage of corn, and the prices and the effectiveness of this ethanol using corn didn't pan out. Had someone done a study and some other energy type thing, and we determined whether this is worth the dollars, or at least reasonably expected to be worth the dollars, but I don't hold any hope for it coming out of the Assembly, because if certain environmental groups rate the bill, you know, they can rate it one smokestack, two smokestacks, three smokestacks, depending on, this was a three smokestack. This is so horrible to the environment that we would have to, we shouldn't do a cost-benefit analysis of where taxpayers' money goes. You get too many smokestacks, and the people just automatically will not vote for a bill.
And shouldn't everything basically have a cost-benefit analysis tied to it?
I would think so. And then one of the arguments, well, it's going to take time. We won't be able to move this money and get these new programs. Well, by that rationale, we shouldn't determine the cost of anything. Let's just do what we want to do, and whatever it costs is fine, and we just keep going back to the taxpayer for more when that fund runs out. So it's a lot of differences of opinion, but that did pass the Senate, and I thank the colleagues that saw the logic of it and voted for it.
Yeah, another bill you have is, it's a tax credit for adaptable housing, for those designed to be accessible for all types of people.
Right, this is called a Visibility Act, and basically we passed it last year. The governor vetoed it, mm-hmm. and justifiably so. There was no outside cost. in other words, the governor say, we don't know what this is going to cost. We've got to have some basis for it. I mean, cost in the sense of the overall cost. How many people are going to be making use of it? In other words, the bill gives a tax credit to the homeowner, to the individual who's putting in things in a house and retrofitting a house, mm-hmm. so that people that have handicapping conditions can be accessible to them. And the governor vetoed it. So we corrected what I believe what will straighten this out, and that is this tax credit. People can use it. The contractors can use it. People paying contractors can use it. But there's a cap on the available credit, how much the state can bear in credit, of $1 million. Now, that's not enough to do what you'd have to do for every household that wanted to make their home accessible to a family member, a friend that happens to have handicapping yeah. conditions. But it at least, I think, will show the worth of it, and hopefully it could be expanded in the future.
Yeah, there was also a bill that passed that establishes the Empire State Music Production Credit and the Empire State Digital Gaming Media Production Credit.
Yes, there's two industries that we want to encourage. Remember, we have the film tax credit,
yep.
Which allows for credits to try to get to try to encourage filmmaking in this area. But primarily, as I've said before on these shows, it primarily benefits New York City. Concept was to promote, to actually expand that to music producers and also to game manufacturers, you know, the video games that mm-hmm. Children and grandchildren are mesmerized by and spend too much time with. Well, that's what that is, to encourage these type of entrepreneurs to be able to stay in New York and take a benefit of a credit to manufacture these. And there's a couple, there's several in upstate New York tied in with universities that have programs for gaming. Mm-hmm. And I don't mean gambling, I mean video gaming. No. And so this is a good bill. But what I did to change it, I have portioned the monies that are available between New York City, the Long Island, as you go upstate, and plus upstate New York, so that it's not like it's a pot of money for New York City again, mm-hmm. so that we would hopefully have some people encouraged to come up to upstate to do this as well.
Very good. When it comes to education, you have been trying to advance the curriculum in a way that it's more fair for all students, as well as just getting them ready to compete in a global marketplace.
That's true, and one of them was, I think it's called USTEM,
yeah.
as I said, there's always a acronym. It's actually primarily dealing with urban youth to try to get them to take STEM courses, the technical courses, engineering, mathematics, and the like. And what this is a program that tries to get children who are in the schools tied up with some company that does technology work and to be mentored and to see how important and how vast the job opportunities are if you're in more technical type subjects. And how that works would be that the companies, again, tax credits, companies don't have to do it, but you get a tax credit for participating in the program and letting children participate in your work. So you hire a child, a high school student, and say his salary is $200 a week. A certain percentage you can get a tax credit for, so you're getting a rebate of some taxes for participating and making your company available to these students. So it's a win-win proposition. That did pass the assembly as well. And hopefully the governor will sign it.
Thank you, Senator, for updating us on how the bills you prioritized are working its way through the process. And thank you to everyone watching. To learn more about the bills discussed today, defrancisco.nysenate.gov.